first and foremost, giving honor to God, who is the head of my life, to House Majority Whip James C. Clyburn, Representative Leon Howard, Mayor Daniel Rickman, City of Columbia councilpersons, Reverend Ed McDowell. Do we have any other city councilpersons here? Ms. Herbert and Taylor. To our county councilperson, Council Lady Yvonne McBride. Do we have anyone else from county council? To the neighborhood representatives, my business partners and investors, families and friends. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
We've come today to officially dedicate this space and to open 34 new businesses here in Columbia. We pause to offer a prayer of thanksgiving for every person and every experience that has made this moment possible. Our hope is that Palmetto Place will bring a new energy, a new light to this area of Columbia, and will become a hub of activities where people will enjoy excellent services. At this time, I welcome my friend and my brother, Reverend Edward McDowell, Councilman District 3, for invocation.
Gracious and eternal Father, for the rich blessings you've bestowed upon each of us, this beautiful day, you've graced us with your presence and with purpose and intent. Lord, we come to this place today, a dream coming alive. Out of vacant buildings have come the resurgence of new possibilities. And Lord, for that, each of us ought to say thank you. You've afforded us through the developer, Brother Gary, and other members to make this place a hub of possibilities. You've given potential and new life to Two Notch Road. And I thank you, no, Lord, that every ounce of potential on Two Notch Road continues to expand the outreach and yet the ministries of this city of ours. Bless us, undergird us, and yet continue to fortify us with your grace and mercy. Bless this building and those who dwell therein, that this may not only be a place of employment, but a place of possibilities. We ask it, we claim it in your name, and every heart said, amen.
On a day like today, when we celebrate the enhanced stability of the economic growth of our community, it is a real pleasure to have our esteemed Congressman James E. Clyburn, to bring an open message to us today and to share in this moment with us. I've known Congressman Clyburn for well over 35 plus years and have watched him every step of the way to have our backs. As he's worked to build the brand and expand the footprint of South Carolina through his nation, we've watched him work for affordable health care, affordable housing, jobs and economic development opportunities, a passionate supporter of historic preservation and restoration programs, which has benefited many of our historically black colleges and universities, and his support for access to broadband for all. Congressman Clyburn has steadfastly worked for the people of South Carolina across racial lines, political lines, for citizens in both the rural and urban communities of our great state. I welcome him here this morning to set the stage for this exciting venture and to share his historic perspective and vision of the future for small businesses as we cut the ribbon of the first of many business ventures along the Two Notch Road corridor and our community, which are designed to improve the quality of life for all Columbia residents. Congressman Clyburn.
And thanks to all of you for being here, to distinguished guests here on the platform. Let me say a couple of things about this venture. My late wife and I came to Columbia right out of South Carolina State back in 1961. And we moved then to Farrell Road. We went to Columbia, went to Charleston from Columbia some 6 or 7 months later. And when we returned in 1965, we returned to this neighborhood over on McFadden Street. And there we lived for a while, and of course, went back to Charleston, where we took over the Neighborhood Youth Corps and New Careers programs, programs designed to give people a chance on life and a chance on professional development. That lasted for a year, and we decided to come back to Columbia. And this time, we moved out into what we now call Greenview, and have been here ever since. Now, as many of you know, I grew up in a parsonage. My father was a pastor in the Church of God, now Clement Road, here in Columbia, but most of you don't remember. It was Pendleton Street, Church of God, now where the university has pretty much taken over. And throughout all of that, I remember a certain passage of scripture that I think about almost every time I participate in a venture like this. It is the book of Hebrews, the 11th chapter, the very first verse. Faith, the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things unseen. I approach projects like this one, my service, with that in mind. The substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. We may not see it, but if we maintain faith, faith in our own human intelligence, faith in those with whom we interact, faith in what is laid out in the preamble of the Constitution of the United States, where it says, in order to create a more perfect union, an admission that this country is not perfect, an admission that we should always be in pursuit of perfection. And a part of that pursuit is making sure that everybody that subscribes to the greatness of this country have that greatness possible for them. That's why you see about every other year, billboards going all up with me saying what my mantra is, to make this country's greatness accessible and affordable, yes, for all of its citizens. Yes. You don't have to ask what you're about. If it's education, yes, we want it to be accessible and affordable. Yes, healthcare, yes, accessible and affordable. Housing, accessible and affordable. Whatever it is that you want. I hear people talking all the time, well, what y'all want? That's what we want. To make everything in this country accessible and affordable. I used to shop for groceries right here when I was over at 1919 McFadden Street. I saw this whole development fade away.
And when I ran for Secretary of State back in 1978, my headquarters was right next to the post office in this building. So I come here today to join all of you in renewing a long-term commitment, not just to this community, but to this site itself. Faith, the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. You may not see it today, but I have faith that you will in the not too distant future. Godspeed.
Just to add a little bit more, I was born and raised in this community. My family, my mother and father, they got married. I was born on McAllister Street, a few blocks over from here. I attended C.E. Johnson High School, W.E. Perry Middle School. And my father started a business in 1955, which is currently being operated by my brother now. And it's now 66 years old, you know, at the business. You can give a round of applause for that. And I always tease our ass, it's not a funeral home. Not many minority businesses last, but they're not funeral homes. I'm proud of this project. I remember as a middle school student at W.A. Perry Middle School, my father would have me ride my bicycle over to make a bank deposit at South Carolina National Bank, which is now Enterprise. And at that time, there was very little traffic. The community was safe that he could give me a bank bag and ask to go make a deposit. Wasn't very much money, Charles, probably $50 or $100, but I could go back in the 60s and 70s and make a bank deposit for the business. And so, as the Congress indicated, I remember Roses 5 and 10, Big Star, just to name a few businesses in this development that we saw fade away. But I'm proud today to be a part of the grand opening of Palmetto Place, even to the extent that I asked my Deputy Research Director for the South Carolina House of Representatives Medical Affairs Committee, Ms. Ava Brumfield, to be here today. She is present here. I'd like to recognize her as well as our security details here today to see this operation. We intend to be a part of this project. I've assigned Ms. Ava to this project to navigate and help business people in this area through any issues that we may have as it relates to the state. And so we've got it covered. We got the federal, we got the state, we got the city and county all on board to make this project, to help make this project a success. Just again, want to say thank everyone involved. Look forward to us working together to renew the life and the strength of this project just as it was many years ago. Thank you so much.
So it's a great day in the city of Columbia. I'm very excited to be here as we celebrate 34 new businesses. This is probably one of the few times that we'll ever have such a big grand opening, and what an excitement that is happening here in Columbia. I think what's more exciting about it all is that out of the 34 businesses here, 27 of them are women-owned businesses. And that's something to celebrate in South Carolina. You know, sometimes we're last in a lot of things, but we're in the top five for the most women-owned businesses in a state. And I think that's something to celebrate. As a father of two daughters, this is what I want them to see, is that whatever they put their mind to, they can achieve. And I think this is a great testimony. And I want to thank Mr. Gary for spearheading this with his partners. This is the beginning. This is the catalyst of revitalization of a corridor to our city, and we need to celebrate it every day. And I want to thank the congressman and everybody else for all their support, and let's continue to uplift these businesses. Let's support them, and let's do everything we can as a community to keep growing. Thank you.
Today is a wonderful day for this community, for the city and Richland County. I'm Yvonne McBride, and I'm your county councilwoman for this district. And it is my honor on behalf of Richland County Council to join the others in saying thank you to the Mr. Gary and the 35 businesses that are here today. I think that this is a momentous day that we should never forget. I remember I grew up in this community too, and I love this area. In fact, I love this area so much, I still live here. And I can remember how excited I was when my family and I would go shopping at this very plaza. It was then known as Midland Shopping Center, which housed my favorite store, Roses. I think it was called Roses 5 and 10. And it went, a dollar went a long way. And I got lots of toys and candy. In fact, I was in candy heaven here. There were other businesses, as mentioned. However, today I'm still excited about the type of businesses that have moved into what is now known as Palmetto Place. Palmetto Place is the path to a one-stop shop for total wellness. That wellness will meet the needs for not only this community, but for the city and the county and beyond. It will meet the needs from beauty to physical and mental health. And all of these things and more can be filled and will be fulfilled right here at Palmetto Place. We must help these businesses build capacity and remain sustainable, which in turn builds a better and stronger community, city, and county. And yes, Congressman Clyburn, I remember when you ran for Secretary of State, because I was right there with you, right here coming and going all over. And much success has come because now he's our congressman. And so I thank you all again. Mr. Garrett, I thank you for your vision, you and your partners, and for making this, for what we will see in the future and beginning now, a vibrant community again. Thank you all for coming. It's so good to see so many of you in the audience that I know. And so we must get the word out to others. We must support these businesses and other small and minority businesses. So I can't say thank you enough for giving me the opportunity to be here and for looking for a wonderful revitalization of this area. Thanks.
At this time, I'd just like to introduce two of my partners that are here, Chris Cashman, Bernice Mellon. Our other part, Ed, is in Connecticut. And I think we may have a few of our investors are here. I thought I saw Julius Thomas Jr. over here. But I just want to thank them for the confidence that they placed in me to take the lead on this development, because this was a ever-evolving development. You know, we started out with climate control storage. And as the story goes, she's counseling. They were over in one of the other properties and they needed space. And she came over here and said, I like the space. This was back in July. We closed in June of last year. And right after that, Tara was looking at a property we have on Forest Drive. And she said, this is not large enough. I said, let me show you something. So I showed her this. She said, I have two sisters that want something. I stuck the sign out here. Mr. Hammack and Mr. Prince, they were going to the post office. They said, you got some office space in there. I said, yeah. He said, we'll take all these offices on this corner. I said, Chris, something is happening here. And then my nephew, who's a photographer, looked at some space, and he brought a friend of his. She said, I'm doing studios out in the Northeast. I want some studio space. So she opened seven studios, and by the end of the first week, all of them were full. So she said, I need more space. I said, Chris, we need to rethink the storage thing. So, and here we are. We have a diaper dispenser, you know, where folks can come get diapers at discount. We have a commissary kitchen that's going to be coming in where, if most of you know about food trucks, most of the food trucks around Columbia are operating illegal. They're supposed to be operating out of a certified D-head kitchen, which we will have one. And we thank you for all the support that you've given us thus far. You know, I also have to thank former council lady Tamika Isaac that was instrumental in helping us get some things, you know, done. And also like to thank our council person Ed McDowell and council person Yvonne McBride. So it's a group effort. And as Representative Howell said, we got federal, we got state, we got city and county. And all of them got COVID money. So when you add all that up, we should have some money. And this time I'd like to introduce Ms. Melissa Linda, who is the director of City of Columbia Office of Business Opportunity, followed by Ms. Erica Wade, who is the manager of Richland County Office of Small Business.
I just want to take this time to thank all of you for being here. Our businesses, where are our businesses at? Business owners, raise your hand. Thank you for choosing Columbia as your home for your business. We thank you, Mr. Gary, for your investment that you made into this community, that you have you continue to make into the community. It did not just start here. We know that. And we're happy that you're looking back and you're making this community, you're revitalizing it, you're investing, your partners are investing, but our businesses are also investing. The Office of Business Opportunities, we're committed to supporting small, minority, and women-owned businesses. So yes, you will have support through the City of Columbia, through our mayor, through our councilmen, but also through this office. We're dedicated to helping you build capacity. We help you with marketing, training, technical assistance, and we also help you with grand openings, because we're excited to celebrate you as a business owner, but we're also excited about the investment that you're making yourselves and in our community. Thank you so much.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Erica Wade. I'm the manager for the Office of Small Business Opportunity at Richland County, and I just want to say thank you to Mr. Gary and to all the partners. Thank you to our members here for supporting Mr. Gary, and to our business owners. This is for you. As the manager for the Office of Small Business Opportunity, and to also you business owners that may be out there, we want to let you know that we're here to support you. We're here for you. We have services where we advocate for you, the small, local, minority businesses in Richland County. We offer services such as capacity building, like Ms. Melissa. We also partner with the City of Columbia. We have advocacy. We also do capacity building. We do one-on-one small business services. So if you need that one-on-one counseling, we got you. We also have goal settings, where we set goals in our contracts so that you, our small, local, and minority businesses, can have opportunities at Richland County. So we want to encourage you to utilize the services that we have available to you. You're right around the corner. I want to recognize your staff that's here. So in the end, if anybody wants to reach out to our small, local business, our OSBO staff, raise your hand, please. Thank you, and we on hand. We also have our county administrator, Mr. Brown. We have our ACA on hand, Mr. Jensen, and some other county administrators that's here. So that shows you that we are here full-heartedly waiting to support you all. But before I take my seat, I want to ask Mr. Gary and his partners to move over to the easel. We have an exciting reveal that we want to show you guys. So as Ms. McBride talked about earlier, in the space behind us, this is, like she said, this is a one-stop shop where you can get your mental, your beauty, your support, your physical needs met. But Mr. Gary realized there was still one thing that was missing. Knowing that this is a food desert, Mr. Gary had an opportunity to meet with Reverend Maloney. And through their collaboration, something beautiful was birthed. As you know, this is a food desert. So ladies and gentlemen, you are the first to know this. We want to reveal to you that the Edgewood Two Notch community will be bringing to the Palmetto Place in the Edgewood community, the Fresh Community Markets IGA grocery store. Vegetables, and also groceries. I want to bring Mr. Gary, I just want to say congratulations, Mr. Gary, for bringing this. I think it was Congressman Clyburn that said he used a grocery shop in his area. Now we're bringing it back.
I'm the founder and CEO of Fresh Communities. Fresh is an acronym that stands for Facilitating Restoration for Equitable and Sustainable Healthy Communities. Yeah. So when I met Mr. Gary, and saw this awesome brainchild that he has put together and is leading the process, I knew that this is where we wanted to be. Literally, we met him about a month and a half ago, and I commissioned my people to go ahead and do the feasibility studies. It is very much in line with a profitable business that can be held here. And I've taken name for everybody who said that they want to help us, But we are excited because this fits facilitating restoration for equitable and sustainable, healthy communities. That is the Fresh Market. Our first store will open in Greenville, Florida, the home of Ray Charles. Our second store will all open in Dawson, Georgia. And then, of course, we will have our flagship store in Waycross. But it looks like Columbia just jumped in the middle of all of that. And we're going to try our best to get this open within the next 6 to 12 months here in Columbia, South Carolina. So thank you so very much. We are excited about coming. We're excited about being here. God bless. Hey, I'm a preacher, so I'm going to sit down. This is the shortest sermon you'll ever hear. Amen.
Also, I'd just like to give a special thanks to several persons who helped put this together. The City of Columbia, County Council, my dear sister of like the past 50-some-odd years, Janice Marshall, and just everybody. I just want to give thanks to everyone. And also our property manager, Kim from Collier's. So if I left anyone out, you know, please just forgive me. At this time, we'll ask the congressman, the mayor, Mr. McBride, Mr. Howell, all these folks on this side.